fifth Sunday of Easter. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, peace from God our Father, be with each one of you. Let us prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. And you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. First reading is from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith in the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
St. Peter, "Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And, like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, 'Behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame.' Therefore, its value is for you who have faith, but for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. According to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to begin by wishing all of our mothers, grandmothers, godmothers, stepmothers, all the women who treat their nieces and nephews, and many of our parishioners like their own children. I wish all of you God's blessings as we celebrate Mother's Day. Because this weekend is a special weekend, my homily is going to be shorter than usual, and then I'm going to add some thoughts on mothers. The scriptures, the opening words of our gospel today from St. John had, "Don't let your hearts be troubled." We have all heard the expression, and possibly have used it ourselves, well, that's easier said than done. And we know there is truth in that. You can say whatever you want, but it's what you do that counts. Don't let your hearts be troubled. How can we not have our hearts troubled by what we see on television in terms of the news, what we see on the internet in terms of this doctor saying that and that doctor saying that? I think part of our unrest, or I should say, part of my unrest, is due to whom or what can I trust anymore? Can I trust our government to tell us the truth? Are we getting what the government wants us to see? Are we getting what the media folks, the editors and controllers, are we seeing only what they want us to see? Is our news selected? And it's very true that we have to be critical instead of just nodding our heads and going along. Whom can we trust? What sources can we trust? The gospel today has that answer. Jesus concludes the passage with, "I am the way and the truth and the life." If our hearts get restless, if we get troubled, then we can look to see if we are putting our faith somewhere it doesn't belong. And this will be a good test for us. If we notice our hearts getting restless and we're getting upset more easily than we used to, then just ask ourselves, are we following Jesus? Is Jesus the way for us? Are we living the truth that Jesus teaches? Do we want to be alive? Do we want life with Jesus? We need to put our faith and trust in the right place. Okay, that's the homily. Now, I told you I'd have some thoughts for moms, for Mother's Day. Won't be long, but if you're at home now, I wouldn't put your head on a pillow. Just stay awake, listen up. It's a story about a mother and her daughter. One day, a little girl was watching her mother do the dishes in the kitchen sink. She suddenly noticed that her mother had several strands of white hair sticking out in contrast to her brunette head. She looked at her mother and said, "Why are some of your hairs white, Mom?" Her mother replied, "Well, every time you do something wrong and make me cry or unhappy, one of my hairs turns white." The little girl thought about this revelation for a while, and then she said, "Mommy, how come all of Grandma's hairs are white?" One time a little girl asked her mother, "What is it like having the best daughter that a mother could ever have?" And her mother replied, "I don't know, dear. You'll have to ask your grandmother." Here are a couple questions that second graders answered. Question: what ingredients are mothers made of? Answer: God makes mothers out of clouds and angel hair and everything nice in the world in one dab of mean. Question: why did your mom marry your dad? Answer: my dad makes the best spaghetti in the world and my mom eats a lot. The other answer to that question is, my grandma says that mom didn't have her thinking cap on. That's why she married the dad. Question: who's the boss at your house? Answer: well, mom doesn't want to be boss, but she has to because dad is such a goofball. Question: what would it take to make your mom perfect? Well, on the inside, she's already perfect. Outside, I think some kind of plastic surgery. If you could change one thing about your mom, what would it be? Answer: I would like for her to get rid of those invisible eyes in the back of her head. Now, this next section deals with experience. Somebody said it takes about 6 weeks to get back to normal after you've had a baby. Somebody doesn't know that once you're a mother, normal is history. Somebody said you can't love the second child as much as you love the first. Somebody doesn't have two or more children. Somebody said the hardest part of being a mother is labor and delivery. Somebody never watched her baby get on the bus for the first day of kindergarten or on a plane headed for a military boot camp. Somebody said a mother's job is done when her last child leaves home. Somebody never had grandchildren. Somebody said your mother knows you love her, so you don't need to tell her. Somebody isn't a mother. And this one is called a mommy test. I was out walking with my 4-year-old daughter. She picked up something from the ground and put it in her mouth. I took the item away from her and asked her not to do that. Why? My daughter asked. Because it's been laying outside and you don't know where it's been. It's probably dirty and has germs, I replied. At this point, my daughter looked at me with total admiration and she asked, how do you know all this stuff? Oh, I was thinking quickly, well, all moms know this stuff. It's on the mommy test. You have to know it or they don't let you be a mommy. Well, we walked along in silence for 2 or 3 minutes and she was pondering this new information. Oh, I get it, she beamed. So if you don't pass the test, then you have to be the daddy. Exactly, I replied back with a big smile on my face and joy in my heart. And this last section is part of what you've probably seen before about church bulletins, not necessarily Mother's Day, but still humorous, and I think we all need some humor in our lives at this point in the pandemic. These were found in bulletins. The fasting and prayer conference includes meals. Scouts are having aluminum cans, bottles, and other items to be recycled. Proceeds will be used to cripple children. Ladies, don't forget the rummage sale. It's a chance to get rid of those things not worth keeping around the house. Bring your husbands. Next Thursday, there will be tryouts for the choir. They need all the help they can get. A bean supper will be held on Tuesday evening in the church. Music will follow. I'm not sure I call it music, but anyway. At the evening service tonight, the sermon topic will be, what is hell? Come early and listen to our choir practice. not our choir. This wasn't in the St. Francis Bulletin then, okay? Please place your donation in the envelope along with the deceased person you want remembered. The ladies in the church have cast off clothing of every kind. They may be seen in the basement on Friday. Low self-esteem support group will meet Thursday at 7 p.m. Please use the back door. The eighth graders will be presenting Shakespeare's Hamlet in the church basement Friday at 7 o'clock. The congregation is invited to attend this tragedy. And finally, Weight Watchers will meet at 7 p.m. at the First Presbyterian Church. Please use the large double door at the side entrance. Anyway, I'm not making this stuff up. Anyway, God bless all of our mothers, living and deceased. Our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the church, that we may find ways to both preach the word and serve our neighbor. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For elected leaders, that they may serve with humility all the people in their care, especially let us pray for our governor, so he can be open to the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord. For mothers, grandmothers, godmothers, expectant mothers, that they may know the values of their nurturing presence and the love of their families, let us pray to the Lord. For first responders, medical people serving in intensive care wards and areas dedicated to the coronavirus, patients with their families, let us pray to the Lord. Let us pause for a moment of silence as we add our own special petitions and intentions. Let us pray for the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts and for vocations to the priesthood and religious life. Let us pray to the Lord. God of all, you sent your only Son to a sinful people, and he shows us the way back to you. Help us always to keep his way firmly in our sights as we make these prayers to you in his name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. And blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed are you, blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, we be accepted by you. May our sacrifice on your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away our iniquity. Present for our sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name. For our good of all his holy church. Amen. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in the sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Partaking of the body and blood of Christ, may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, her spouse, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. May this make the body of our Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us and our Savior. Our Jesus Christ, Son of the Holy Spirit, say the word, my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ. May the blood of Christ give me safe.
Let us go and have a good day. Happy Mother's Day.